Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. In this video, we're going to talk about a bushcrafted winch. How you can make a winch when out in the woods. Oftentimes you may need to pull out a stump. You may need to move a big log. You may need to pull your boat up onto the shore. You may need to get your four-wheeler unstuck. There's many uses for a winch. So, let's get started. Let's see how it's put together and how to use it. Okay, we've got a rope secured onto the four-wheeler. And at the other end, we're ready to secure it around a good solid anchor, which in this case happens to be a tree. Now, here's the winch, or I should say the winch handles. Let's get started in setting them up. Okay, to string the rope, to get it started, we lay the bottom one parallel to the rope. Okay, and then we lay the side one on top of the bottom one. Now we go across this side of the top pole, not this side. Go across this side, go underneath the bottom one and around the top one. Okay, let's do a close-up with this. Okay, the four-wheeler is this way, the tree is this way, okay? So, the bottom one goes parallel to the rope, the top one, the sideways one lays across the bottom one. Okay, we take the rope across the top of the sideways one on this side of the parallel pole, not this side. Okay, now loop it under and loop it over the top one. Okay, and there it is. That's how we get started. Now we can go ahead and tighten up the rope on the tree. Okay, now we can pull it tight around the tree. What we're going to do now is we're going to take this, make a complete revolution, reach through, grab the bottom, and pull it through, make a bite. Now we're going to pull this through, and we're going to pull this all the way through the end. Okay, cinch this up fairly tight. Come through, make a loop. Now we're gonna come through again and tighten up this loop. Okay, now these knots that I'm using are not critical. You can use any number of knots. These are just the knots that I'm using. All right, let's get started with the winching. This is called the flip-flop winch. It was developed, or at least popularized, by Mors Kochanski, a popular Canadian bushcraft instructor. All right, now your poles are gonna need some stout enough poles to handle the job, to handle the forces applied against them. All right, now how long you make the poles would depend on your job at hand. The longer the poles, the more leverage you're going to have. Of course, it goes without saying you're going to need rope that's strong enough for the job. All right, let's go ahead and get started here. Now, notice I have a loop here that I'll slip over this to hold it in place. Okay, we flip that pole. Now we're going to flop this pole. Hence the name, flip-flop winch. Okay, notice I put a stake in here. I'm doing this by myself. So you need to make a few tweaks in order to accomplish this by yourself. This being one of them. This will hold this pole in place. Okay, this tree over here is holding that pole in place on the other side. Okay, and this rope is holding this pole in place. And same with this end. I've got a loop here around the rope to hold it in place. Okay, now as you're winding this up, you want the rope to be tight. Roll up tight, as close as you can to the center pole. Okay, this four-wheeler is over 400 pounds, so you can see that I'm moving it almost effortlessly through the leverage provided by these poles. And as I said earlier, this winch can be a useful bit of knowledge to have filed away, because there's often times when you need to move a stump out of your campsite or move a log or the four-wheeler, get a four-wheeler on stock, snow machine, whatever. As you can see, this works pretty good. Okay, now you may get to a point where as the four-wheeler is coming forward, this whole winch is moving up the rope. So you may want to stop now and then, undo it all, and relay out the poles, cinch the rope back up, and start over. So hope you learned something, and I'm glad that you joined me today. I really appreciate you being here. So you guys have a good one, and you take care. Have a good week. We'll see you on the next video.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.